Welcome friends, lecture 4, ledger posting from journal. So what you have learned so far, let us have a recap. We discuss about the basic terms, we discuss about debit and credit rules, types of accounts, accounting process, and we also studied about journal. So here is the next step forward, and here we are going to discuss about the ledger posting from journal. In accounting procedure, we discussed in the previous lecture that we have a recording to be done in journal, posting and classification to be done in ledger, and summary has to be made through trial balance. So the trial balance will come in the next lecture. This is little smaller in slides, this topic, ledger posting, but very, very crucial and very, very important for us to understand. If you are a beginner, you have to understand it very, very clearly with full patience. Don't rush to the slides very, very fast. Listen to what I am saying with a clear mind. That yes, this is something going to become base for us. So let's start with this. What is a ledger? Ledger contains the entire group of accounts maintained by the company. Now, whatever journal entries you are going to make, out of that we will make some ledger. And in that ledger, we will have more accounts, all accounts. Now, what is a ledger? Always remember, it is a book which contains all accounts. Sometimes students are always saying, ledger is account, ledger is accounts. No, ledger is not accounts. Ledger is the book in which all the accounts are maintained. Now, a general ledger contains all the assets, liability, owner equity, revenue and expense account. If I just give you a clue again, it will have all type of real account, personal account and nominal account. Alright, and every account will be unique, that I will tell you what exactly I am talking about. So this is the same example we have covered in lecture number 3, in which we discuss about the journal, and this was the end result of that query, where we had some 5 transactions. These transactions are cash account, ABC, furniture, account payable, receivable, service revenue, account payable, cash, salary expense, cash. The moment you are through with the journal in any course, any part, any company so far, always remember, when we plan to make a ledger, we have to maintain unique accounts. Means there will not be any duplicate account with single name. I hope I am getting clear. There will not be any more than one account for one name. So if we just focus here, we have cash account. So how many account will be made for cash? One. ABC? One. Third account, office furniture. Fourth account, accounts payable. Fifth, account receivable. Sixth, service revenue. Then again we get account payable. Are we going to make another account? No, because for account payable already we made an account. So we cannot have two accounts. Only one account will be maintained and these two entries will be transferred from here to that one account only. Cash, again we already have one account, no two accounts. Salary expense, yes we have to make. And cash again, no need to maintain, separate account. So understanding this, always remember, we do not make double accounts or triple accounts with single name. Only one name and one account will be opened. So looking at this, if you just cross check, we have to identify the number of accounts to be prepared. And how to identify? I just told you, just count on number, name of the account. It should not be repeating again. If it is repeating, no need to open another account. So first account will be cash, ABC Capital, office furniture, accounts payable, account receivable, service revenue and salary expense. So total 7 accounts will be opened and these all accounts will be in the form of T. I hope you remember we discussed in our lecture number 2 where we discuss about types of accounts. All the accounts are having a shape of T. The left side is going to be the debit and the right side is going to be the credit. So let us understand how these accounts are going to be maintained. Now these accounts, I have given you the sample, like we have cash account, ABC Capital account, office furniture account, accounts payable account, account receivable account, salary expense account and service revenue account. All these accounts I have put in the form of T. T-shape. All right. So now how I have to start posting my entries? Let us start with the journal. We have cash account, debit, ABC, credit. Now, some teachers always teach in a different way. Nobody is bad teacher. It's all like that we have a different way of teaching. Now, some people teach that, okay, you start with cash account first, prepare it first, then capital account, then office furniture account, then account payable account, like this. But that can be a little confusing because we might forget some or the other entry. So my suggestion goes is, take one entry full, debit and credit simultaneously. So if I am writing cash account, debit 50,000, it means that on cash account, in cash account, on the debit side, write 50,000. Right? So what I will do, I will write 50,000 here for transaction number 1. Go back simultaneously, ABC capital, credit 50,000. So in ABC capital account, what we have prepared, on this credit side, put 50,000. Transaction 1, 50,000. See, we have done like this. January 1, transaction 1, 50,000. Cash, January 1, transaction 1, 50,000. If we are going to put these entries simultaneously, you will never do any mistake. But if you are going to put entry for cash and you search cash and then you ABC capital, ABC, you will search. But right now the example is only for 5 to 6 transactions. But in real time, in the courses you are doing, you may have 30-40 entries. That time it will be very troublesome. So go entry wise entry. Entry means complete debit and credit and respective accounts should be posted. Always remember, in ledger we post entry from journal. Second entry we have is office furniture 5,000, accounts payable 5,000. So office furniture debit 5,000 with transaction number 2. So see how we have done this. Office furniture debit 5,000, transaction number 2, January 4th. And simultaneously we have to pay to accounts payable. So accounts payable credit. So accounts payable credit 5,000, transaction number 2, January 4th. This is the way we are just entering all entry completely simultaneously. No need to go separately. Third, January 6th, accounts receivable to be debited with 8,000. So see what we did. In account receivable, we debit transaction number 3, 8,000. Simultaneously, we have got service revenue, credit 8,000. So in service revenue account, transaction number 3, credit 8,000. So January 6th. I hope by now you are getting some understanding that all transactions should be, entry should be simultaneously posted to respective debit and credit accounts. Here debit means on the debit side write this amount, on the credit side write this amount, like this. Next entry is accounts payable, January 24th, debit, cash, credit. So what we did, in accounts payable we will debit. So in account payable we will debit 2,000, transaction number 4, January 24th, and we have paid cash. So in cash, transaction number 4, 2,000 simultaneously has been entered, posted. Salary expense debit, cash, credit. So now on the salary account we will debit it and cash we will credit. So salary account, salary expense will be debited with the amount and transaction number 5, and cash will be done here, transaction number 5. So we will write like this, salary expense, transaction number 5, 5,500, and January 30th, transaction number 5, cash account credited with 5,500. This is the simple way. Here I will suggest you immediately take a break, go back, and from where I started teaching you this method, again come back till this point. Alright, because you can stop it anytime you want to stop. You can stop it, you can rewind it, come back again, so that it is getting into your mind clearly that how we are doing posting from journal to ledger. Now I move forward. You want to rewind, you can rewind and come back. I move forward. We call it. Now, this is the account closed? Or have we balanced the ledger? We normally hear the jargon, the simple statements like, have you balanced the ledger? Have you got your accounts closed? It means that you have to check out for every account. We have a debit balance, we have some credit balance. Now, if we say this debit balance and this credit balance, this is a wrong statement. I repeat, normally we say it is a debit balance, it is a credit balance, it is a wrong statement. Why it is a wrong statement? This is debit side total, this is credit side total. Balance will be, on debit we have 50,000, on credit we have 7,500. 7,500. So how much amount is more in debit? That is my balance. So in the debit, I have excess of 50,000 minus 7,500. That is 42,500 is the balance on the debit side. That is the concept of balance. So if debit is more, it is a debit balance. If it is credit is more, it is a credit balance. I hope this concept is getting clear to you, so we understand the balancing of accounts. So it is written clearly for your understanding. If debits are greater than credits, the account will have a debit balance. So it's an example. It is not a continuation of that. The same example, we'll continue that. So it is, say some account name is there. We have debit balance, we have credit balance. On the debit side, we have 18,000, 10,000 plus 8,000. On the credit side, we have 3,000. So that means the balance will be 15,000. How come 15,000? 18,000 minus 3,000. So the debit balance is 15,000. Now, if the debit is less than the credit, or the credit is greater than the debit, so it says if credits are greater than the debits, the account will have a credit balance. So if you see the transaction number 2 and 3, 3,000 plus 8,000, 11,000, and this is 10,000. So here we have 1,000 excess in the credit, so it becomes 1,000 of credit balance. So we write down like this, 1,000 in the credit side is more, so that becomes credit balance. So for all the accounts we have done, if you look at these accounts carefully, before I give you a solution, let us understand this part clearly. Cash account, 50,000 is very great amount on the debit side, and the 7,500 on the credit side. So of course it is a debit balance. In ABC Capital account, we have only 50,000 on the credit, so definitely nothing is there, so it is a credit balance. Office furniture account, it is a debit balance. Accounts payable, 2,000 and 5,000 on the credit, so definitely 5,000 is greater than the debit balance. It is going to be 3,000 credit balance. Account receivable, 8,000, nothing on the credit side, so 8,000 debit balance. 5,500 salary expense, debit balance. Service revenue, 8,000 credit side, credit balance. So how we are going to show it in the accounts? This is the way we have to just show our balances. So we write balance debit 42,500, balance credit 50,000, balance debit 5,000, balance credit 3,000, balance debit, don't look at the color, it is different, I suppose I forgot to mention the color. Balance debit 8,000, balance debit 5,500, and balance credit 8,000. These balances are very important to understand how we are going to get it, because if we are not clear with these balances, our next lecture cannot be done. Next lecture is about trial balance. So this is about the ledger where we discuss about from the journal we did in lecture number 2. We post all these entries into identified number of accounts into their respective places of debit and credit, and then we understand the balancing of account. And then for the same example, we had the balances. So till this video, I will suggest you, if you are working on your basics with full patience, go to lecture 1, 2, 3, 4 till this point again, so that before you start lecture number 5 and 6, you are clear about some of the accounting. Because now, after 4th lecture, you cannot say I am new to accounting. Now you know a bit of accounting. And bit by bit, you're going to learn more and more advanced courses. So this is all about this lecture number 4. Now we are going to meet in lecture number 5, which will be talking about, as I mentioned you clearly, these balances will be used for trial balance. So these balances are important to understand the trial balance. So please be focused, learn it thoroughly, understand it, and then come to lecture number 5. Till then, happy learning.